Ella McCauley at Pray It Up in Syracuse, New York. And Jean just said it was a good thing I stopped when I did at the end of the last block, but she was afraid I was going to say something bad to people, but I don't say anything bad to people. I want to talk about, does God expect me to be perfect? God never misses the big picture, and He has given us the free will, to manage our own thought life, our own decisions. We will fail. But here's where Jesus comes into the picture. He literally bore the punishment you and I deserve to pay. And that was on the cross, but so was love. Love and justice. Mercy and punishment. Sin and grace. The innocent lamb being sacrificed on the altar of the cross. When you accept the fact that Jesus bore this sentence you and I deserve, our sin is completely washed away. Without that washing away of sin, no one is even close to perfect in God's eyes. And I think that is so powerful, because I don't think it's good to go to confession and firmly resolve and say, well, God knows I'm going to sin, so I'm just going to go and rob a bank now and just confess it next week. But if you're really trying, if you're doing the best you can, how can we try without becoming a perfectionist, without constantly getting weighed down with guilt and feeling of inadequacy? Have you ever, like, said something bad to someone and then go, oh, why did I say that? Yeah, I have too. And then at least that why did I say that is the God is coming back into us and saying, learn from this. The only way to properly aim for perfection as a Christian is to forget about yourself. It's not about you. You are not perfect, but God loves you just the same. And one of my Bible verses today, one of my readings, it said, the Lord's Prayer, give us this day our daily bread. And so many of us think it's about food. Give us our bread so we can eat. But giving our daily bread is our sustenance for the day. And sometimes that is a kind word that we can give someone else, a helping hand. It's what gets us out of bed, keeps us going. The food does our body. But the daily bread is more than just food. It's the Word of God which feeds our souls. Also, this transformational truth that God loves us even when we sin liberates our hearts and souls and minds. We can aim for perfection without beating ourselves up every time we miss the mark. If we think we're good enough on our own merits to get into God's heaven, that we can just work hard. There's this one person I know, she's kind, she's loving, she's wonderful, and she doesn't believe in God. And she says, I just have a feeling that, you know, if there is a heaven, that I'll be judged on the kind of life I lived. And I said to her, there either is a God or there isn't. So why don't you just believe in God? And if there is one, you're covered. And if there isn't one, what do you got to lose?
Right.
There is or there isn't. So I always say, I'm betting on Jesus, because what do I have to lose? It's a better bet than the casino. Don't ask Jean that, because she might have But I have learned, St. Paul wrote, I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation. Do you think St. Paul was a sinner? Yes, everyone's a sinner, but the Blessed Virgin and Jesus. Forgetting what is behind and straining towards what ahead, I press on towards the goal. St. Paul said, forget what is behind, strain towards what is ahead. Does he say casually stroll towards what is ahead? Strain towards what ahead. The perfect one inspires his imperfect followers to find out what pleases the Lord. Now I want to talk about, is trying to be a perfectionist or your personality making you put on weight? I think there's people in this group that their personality is not helping their weight loss. And I just want to talk about a couple of them. I've talked about the night owl before. These are people who stay up all night and they go to bed too late and their whole hormone system, it gets screwed up, and they're looking for comfort food, and you really need to plan your sleep accordingly. It's just like anything else you do in life. Do I want to go to bed at 9:30 every night? I look at my husband and I go, we got him from work, we ate dinner, and now it's bedtime? Where does the night go? I wish the day went that fast. We go to bed at 9:30 because we need our sleep. Ever since I started going to bed earlier, I feel better and I started to lose weight again. The stress junkie. I don't think I want stress in my life, but there are times where I think some of us look for it. And then that cortisol stimulates a brain chemical that boosts our carbohydrate cravings. There's a book called Don't Sweat the Small Stuff. If we sweat the small stuff, then we're sweating everything pretty soon. There's nothing wrong to saying this. It took me years to learn it. Who cares? It doesn't matter. I used to think that everything mattered. That's what perfectionists do. Everything matters. Everything matters. No, it doesn't. Exercise helps. What you need, it says, I love these books. 50 ways to soothe yourself without food, but I deserve this chocolate. And then she says, really what you deserve is to feel good in your clothes. Now, here's another personality task that I think a personality trait that a lot of people in this room have. The mindless multitasker. That you work, read, drive, watch TV, and do everything while you're eating. That you can't, when I watch a show on TV, I'm checking emails, answering tasks, texts. I said to Bob the other night, I'm just going to sit here and do nothing. And he actually had to get up and look and see. I don't think I've ever seen you do nothing. I go, is talking about it doing something? Am I doing something? Am I talking about doing nothing? I think I am. But the point is, I am guilty of it. And then I like this, mindless eating when we eat more than we think. The fix is keep track of everything you eat for several days. Well, we've been doing it for several weeks, several months, several years. But I will encourage people to be more honest on their food logs. Like, if you're having condiments, if you're having dressings, if you're having, like, people say, well, I only had 5 little candy bars. I'm only going to write it down when I get to 6 little candy bars, because then it counts. All of it counts. I'm not even bringing up Halloween. Is that coming up? Oh yeah, it's Monday. One of the things I don't think I talked about, but it's in the small group. You don't have to raise your hand. I don't know where I wrote it, but somewhere I wrote about eating candy. Let me see where I did, because it's important. I said, all right, let me see. Well, wait a minute. What's today? No.
It's next
see,
week.
I'm so far ahead with my meetings, it's next week. So forget it. We'll talk about candy next week. The perfectionists like givers. Oh, the giver. Most people in the group are givers. People who constantly put other people's needs ahead of their own often become emotionally depleted and seek solace in eating. Mom, can you babysit, please? Well, it's my pray-it-off night. I really need to go to the meeting. I made a commitment. But Mom, I got tickets to see Once, and you know I work so hard and I try so hard. Please, babysit Mom, please. No, I'm sorry, honey. It's my pray-it-off night. You'll have to find someone else. But there is no one else. They never stop. They go on and on and on. But how can you do it? Can you say, well, remember, honey, I told you I made a commitment, and I'm not going to break it. That's the hard part for givers. That's the hard part. You need to set reasonable limits. Like givers, people who drive themselves to be perfect often use food to relieve the pressure. This one next article talks about a woman who actually, a doctor, gained weight on SlimFast. There are a lot of people in this room that think they're doing well. They're looking at their food log, they're looking at their movement, and they're saying, why can't I lose weight? What made this person fail was her inability to accept her own faults. She was trying too hard to have everything in her life perfect. When she didn't meet those goals, she went into anxiety and depression. Overweight perfectionists think in all or nothing terms. Set shorter, more attainable goals. We've talked about that before. Don't weigh yourself every day, once a week here. Work on thinking in the middle. Here's the middle. I want to lose 50 pounds. That's here. I want to lose maybe 1 pound a week. I want to gain 20 pounds. Does anyone want to gain 20 pounds? No. You want to lose 50, how about 1 pound a week? Think in the middle. Also, I'm going to stop right there, Bob. One more.